I tell you, for you being here, and you both have actually to come and help me, but you are able to do just that. That means it's a privilege to have you. Basically, I'm just here to do my projects that you have sent to me. And subjects or the thing that I like to elaborate on is discipline. Discipline, so say it's discipline.
Discipline.
We all know and we have heard this word several times. The resistance that we human beings should normally do that we don't take the time to find meanings of words and how you speak it will be to us. Therefore, this moment I will do this challenge to us to know the meaning of discipline. Therefore, I ask, what is the meaning of discipline in your own words?
Okay. Discipline means obeying rules and regulations.
So basically, discipline is talks about rules and regulations. So the ability of anyone to follow this set of rules and regulations gives that person the go ahead to enjoy the privileges of that society or that organization. And with that idea in our mind, we will move on to the next aspect of this subject, that is self-discipline. I would like to explain that because of time, we move on very fast. Self-discipline. So self-discipline is the ability that one has to control or motivate him or herself, and also to stay in track in achieving or in doing what is right. So self-discipline is the ability of anyone either motivate or control him or herself and stay in track in achieving or doing the right thing. So I'll give an example to that. That's, you know that you need to be at school at 7 a.m. And being at school at 7 a.m. is the right thing. So you will not take it upon yourself that you need to wake up either an hour or 2 or 3 before that 7 a.m. And as you wake up, you know that you need to go and sweep, fetch water, and do other housework. So as you do those things continually, then you'll be referred to as a self-disciplined person. How that is clear? All right, I will move on and give you some few things as well. That reasons for you. Self-discipline becomes very powerful. Self-discipline becomes very powerful when combined with goal setting, passion, and planning. Self-discipline becomes very powerful when combined with goal setting, passion, and planning. As long as you are, we have a lot of things in mind that you want to become. That is why we say that I want to become a doctor, engineer, a pilot, journalist, and the rest. That is your goal. In the next 5, 10 years, 15 years, this is a place that I want to be. It's your goal. And the passion is what drives you or in achieving that goal. And a self-disciplined person has a passion. And that passion is being driven by the goal. And if you have a goal and a passion, it doesn't end there. You need to plan. So those three things come together to give us a powerful self-disciplined individuals in the society. ways we can self-discipline. And I'll pick the points out of the earlier ones that I've raised. One, you need to write down your goals and make sure you do everything in your power to stick to them. A self-disciplined person is the one that will write down his or her goals and do everything within his or her power and achieve them. Two, a self-disciplined person always finishes any task he or she sets before moving on to another one. Stand up that okay, I feel like doing this thing. So you just stand up and just start to do it. Earlier on, I stated that self-discipline becomes very powerful when combined with goal setting, passion, and planning. So you have a goal, so you stick to that goal. You don't just start it and you don't complete and you end on the way. That's on the best way. And the third point that I have here that I think any days, doing everything possible. Doing everything possible to help you experience the satisfaction of your goals. Doing everything possible to help you experience self-discipline becomes very powerful when combined with goal setting, passion, and planning. So you need to do everything possible, and everything possible talks about everything good. And as we have defined discipline as the rules and regulations governing the society or an organization. So everything possible must be of a standard of the good that have been in the organization or in the society. So those are the few things that I'd like to share with you this moment. And my name is Gbadago Justice, the nominee for the award of Student Personality of the Year